Willkommen zur letzten Folge in dieser Session von Rachel Foster. Wir haben hier irgendein, ja, altes Kinderzimmer in der Erde gefunden. Krasse Kacke.
Did you get out of there?
You know by any chance if Rachel wore a retainer?
Maybe. There was an article saying they hadn't found it at the site of the suicide.
I remember. She always made a horrible noise when she clipped it onto her palate with her tongue.
What does Rachel's retainer have to do with anything?
I found a box. It could be hers.
Why should someone keep a 10-year-old retainer?
Maybe they're not just keeping it. Maybe they're using it. The box is empty.
No way. I can't...
Let me go on.
Warte mal. Die Sprachtherapie. Unser Vater hat dir also beigebracht, wie man spricht. Aber wozu? Märchenbücher? Und unsere Mutter wusste ja augenscheinlich davon, wenn sie dieses Versteck hat. Aber warum hat unser Vater uns das Rätsel gegeben? Wir hätten das ja schon viel früher hier entdecken können, theoretisch. Der Schlüssel für oben, wa?
Hey, can you hear me?
Yes.
We have to call someone. You have to get out of there right now.
No. I found a key. It's from my old music box. The one in Leonard's room.
I'm having a hard time following.
If everything in here is Rachel's, then why is my music box's key here?
I don't know and I don't want to know. Tell you what I think, someone could have been in your room.
Was, das ist doch nicht egal.
It doesn't matter.
How can you be so calm?
If someone was in there, he's not here now. I need to grab the chance to figure out what the hell is going on, or went on, here.
Mich würde das auch sehr interessieren.
Yes.
Nicole, listen. I already know what you're gonna say, but please trust me. Get out of there.
No way.
You do realize you found the replica of a dead girl's bedroom. This is sick. This is a
The more things get freaky, bizarre, and painful, the more I need to figure out why. Why all of this?
We'll figure it out with the sheriff. Once you're out of there, into a safe hotel room in town. Please, just...
Listen, a bunch of strange things happened since I got here. Think about it. Phone calls on a dead line. Old lipsticks that don't go bad. Leonard's notes where he says he saw a girl that's supposedly been dead for 10 years, and now this!
All good reasons to get out of there. We both agree that saving your skin is top priority, right?
I've looked over every inch of this place, and there's no one.
If it's true, you realize what that means?
What? What are you trying to tell me?
Your father... He spent years in there. Total solitude. With the weight of his family and Rachel in his conscience, he wasn't the kind of guy to just let the past slide with a shrug. You know that too.
You're joking, right? You think he did this?
Think about it. That room could be an act of love. Distorted, even morbid, but in his eyes...
How dare you? My father might have had a lot of weaknesses, but surely, what you're saying... Leave out that he cheated on my mom, leave out that he fell in love with a 16-year-old, but fucking hell, don't you dare even think that!
I...
He would never have built a fucking underground shrine for a dead person!
Your father had changed in the end. You didn't spend time with him, but I met him, and I'm telling you.
No! I don't give a shit about what you have to say.
I just want you to know that...
If you don't want to help discover the truth, don't call me.
Ich kann beide Seiten verstehen. Sie und ihn. Ich frage mich durch die verschiedene
Asshole. How dare you? You don't know shit. You don't know fuck. Finally, a bit of peace and quiet. It'll help me clear my head without those incessant phone calls. I'm not a fucking switchboard, for fuck's sake. Okay, let me piece things together. I just found out there's a room dedicated to Rachel Foster in my father's hotel. Maybe with items from her real room. Holy Jesus, that's freaky. Some people think she didn't commit suicide, and some even think she's still alive. Maybe if I think through my steps, I can work something out. First thing, the phone call. They said Rachel isn't dead. Then, the lipstick from 10 years ago turns up, still good. And then, my father's various notes where he says he still sees her. If that were true, it might explain the sighting by her friend here in the Timberline. And now I find her retainer box, but no retainer. That room might not be a reconstruction. If Rachel didn't kill herself, Rachel could have lived here. But if she's still alive, why doesn't she tell her parents? Unless they're all in cahoots. No suicide, no Timberline money. No, I'm just being paranoid. And then, there'd be no reason for her to live in a fucking underground replica of her room. My key in the middle of Rachel's stuff. Is it a message? Where do I fit in? Are you trying to tell me something, Dad? My music box with the hockey player. I don't think I have the guts to hear that tune again. But I must.
Also am Anfang hat sie sich selbst belogen. Von wegen, dass sie froh ist, dass er nicht mehr, der Irving nicht mehr anruft. Das erschließt sich mir eben auch noch nicht so ganz. Warum sollte sie hier in so einem Zimmer leben? Obwohl die Mutter vielleicht dann doch nicht Bescheid weiß. Vielleicht waren hier wirklich dann die Gegenstände. Und danach wurde es erst zum Zimmer. Krass, ey. Ich bin echt gespannt, wie das jetzt ausgeht. Ob wir Rachel antreffen werden. Und falls ja, warum das alles verheimlicht wurde. Und das macht Sinn, wenn die Telefonleitung tot ist, tatsächlich. Wobei ich mich immer noch frage, wie der Anwalt auf dem AB dann sprechen konnte. Dass der Anruf dann vielleicht ein interner Anruf war. Dass auf dem Dachboden vielleicht auch noch ein Telefon steht. Und dort jemand angerufen hat, aber es war eine männliche Stimme. Wer kann das denn also sein? Und ich find's eigentlich echt krass, die Spielwelt ist hier eigentlich relativ klein. Und trotzdem ist es ein echt gutes Spiel. Es gibt nicht viel, sehr viel zu entdecken, so, aber ich bin bisher echt begeistert vom Game hier. Wobei viel, nicht viel zu entdecken ist auch eigentlich falsch. Es gibt dafür, dass es nur so relativ kleiner Bereich ist, doch sehr viel zu entdecken. Aber leider nicht, steht nicht bei jedem Gegenstand irgendwas dabei. Die Frage ist, sind wir das? Auch schon gelöst. Und warum sollte Rage dann nicht eigentlich hier oben leben, ey? Warum unten das Zimmer? Das verstehe ich alles nicht.
The 27th of December, 1983. The hockey finals at Missoula. Us against Cold Springs High. We won by sudden death after a three-hour game, and I got the medal for the most number of face-offs won. According to the papers, that was the night Rachel killed herself. Coming home, Mom barely had the time to pull into the garage, that I was already racing up to you, waving the medal in your face, Daddy. I was so happy. But you had other things on your mind, right? And you and Mom started fighting. Voices getting louder. That long silence when she comes down the stairs with the suitcases and Mrs. Bryce tries to stop her. Mom's car stays here, and we leave with my Uncle John's. I never found out what started that fight. Mom never wanted to talk about it. Are you trying to, Daddy?
Wurde es so ausgelegt, dass sie Selbstmord begangen hat, weil sie schwanger war?
Irving.
Finally.
I know I told you to go to hell.
I was dying on this chair.
You're right. That room freaked me out. So, I looked around the entire hotel, and if there's still a chance of getting to the bottom of this story, then it's gotta be behind the locked door on the last floor, in the attic.
That wing has been condemned for years.
I know. I'll be careful.
Okay.
There are too many things that I took for granted. It's as if someone was putting pieces of my past in front of me to show them to me under another light.
Who are you talking about, Nikki?
Maybe it's my father. In my music box, I found the medal I won the night Rachel died. Dad could have put it there, and if he did, there must be a reason.
It all sounds insane.
The night Rachel died. Maybe I have to start from there. I played in that really long hockey game. But what was going on in the meantime? You remember that night, Irving?
I think I was at church with my family.
Church? That night we had a mass for the poor here. We held one every year. As usual, Mom volunteered to take me to the game, but she was so busy with the soup kitchen that I was afraid she was going to be late. I remember while she ran around, she said she ordered me to close the mezzanine.
You mean the intermediate floor above the reception? What's in there?
A storeroom.
Have you been up there?
No, I'd forgotten all about it. I'd better take a look before moving on.
Über der Rezeption? in der Messassine, oder wie auch immer das ausgesprochen wird. Kann ich eigentlich in die Karte reinzoomen? Nein. Da, in der Eingangshalle, müsste ich theoretisch irgendwie da hinkommen. Das ist die Rezeption. Ist eine... Wie ist diese Kamera nie aufgefallen und wo ist denn... Krass wäre es noch, wenn die sich bewegen würde. Ich wollte gerade fragen, wo sind denn die Fernseher für die Überwachungskamera oder der Fernseher? Vielleicht auf dem Dachboden. Über der Rezeption. Das hier? Nee. Obwohl... Aber es ist ja auch nicht über, das ist ja nebenan. Aber über ist ja nur das Ding. Ah. Puppen. In jedem scheiß Horrorspiel Puppen. Die Frage ist ja sowieso, wozu überhaupt? Oh, unser alter Hockeyspieler. In Baby, also Rachel. Scary.
Irving? Hello? Can you hear me? I'm on the mezzanine, and it's a nightmare. There are mannequins everywhere. They're set up like in a scene. There's one with a hockey stick. Wait, what the fuck? That's my stick! If you're listening to me, whoever set up this representation, I think they want to tell me that Rachel... was killed? But why my hockey stick? Hello? Hello? Oh God, why isn't he answering? Irving, I swear I'm not kidding. This is a huge deal. If you can hear me, it's time to make that phone call.
Das heißt, wenn sie ermordet wurde. Diese Geräusche.
Where are you, Nicole?
It's about time. Did you hear my messages?
How many doors have you opened, Nicole? How many are still missing?
What?
What? Are you drunk?
Keep going.
Hello? Hello, Irving.
Das war doch aber Irvings Stimme, oder? Steht aber niemand. Mysteriöse Stiefel. Und eine frische frische Wasserlache. Oh shit. Ich würde sagen, wir machen in der nächsten Folge weiter. Spitz, bedanke mich. Bis dann.